Finally, tonight, we will hear from the Anima trio. Joanna Foster's stunning a cappella trio, Anima, sing inspirational songs of enchantment and soul quests, a magical fusion of jazz and soul. Anima means soul and breath of life. Following in the footsteps of Bobby McFerrin and Sweet Honey in the Rock, the Anima a cappella trio cover a wide musical terrain, from the exhilarating upbeat energy of jazz, through rhythmic soul numbers, to haunting Irish folk. Tonight, they will be performing O Mistress Mine from Twelfth Night and two sonnets set by Katie Rose. Please welcome to the stage the Anima Trio.
Could you put your hands on your tummies and just go, ha ha?
Ha ha.
Ha ha.
Ha
ha. Thank you, that's very nice. Just shake your hands in the sky a bit. Yeah, we've just been sitting still. It's been really exciting, and also we've been sitting still, so we're just kind of shaking ourselves out of it. I'm just going to shout out something, you shout back. Oleo!
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 Oleo! Oleo! Oleo! Oleo!
Oleo!
Oleo!
Oleo!
Oleo!
Oleo!
Oleo!
Thank you very much. Katie.
Thank you. I just want to say thank you so much. I wasn't expecting her to do that. Just then. I just want to say thank you so much, particularly to Rafiq for inviting me, and Mohammed and Salim and the team here, particularly Layla and Noreen, who have dealt with all the endless email trails that I have sent about inquiries. So thank you so much. And the hospitality here has been phenomenal. Phenomenal. I'm just so delighted to be here to be celebrating the diversity of our experience of Shakespeare. It is, you know, I also had my head hit with the sonnets when I was at A level. And fortunately, I enjoyed the experience and did come out with a sore head sometimes. But to accept the challenge of being asked to set the sonnets to music has been an extraordinary experience. So you're going to hear two sonnets, but also two songs from Jo, the first of which is just coming up now.
Mistress, oh my mistress, mine, oh mistress, oh my mistress. Mistress, oh my mistress, mine, oh mistress, oh my mistress. Oh mistress mine, where are you roaming?
Oh my mistress.
Oh stay and hear your true love's coming. That can sing both high and low. That can sing both high and low.
Mistress, oh my mistress, mine.
Mistress, oh my mistress, mine. Trip no further, pretty sweeting. Journey's end and lovers meeting. Every wise man's son doth know.
Mistress, oh my mistress, mine. Oh mistress, oh my mistress.
Mistress, oh my mistress, mine, oh mistress, oh my mistress. Oh what is love, 'tis not hereafter.
Mistress, oh my mistress.
Present mirth hath present laughter.
Mistress, oh my mistress.
What's to come is still unsure. What's to come is still unsure.
Mistress, oh my mistress, mine.
mistress, oh my mistress mine. In delay there lies no plenty, then come kiss me sweet and twenty. Youth's a stuff will not endure.
Mistress, oh my mistress mine, oh mistress, oh my mistress, oh mistress mine, where are you roaming?
Oh stay and hear your true love's coming.
Mistress, oh my mistress,
that can sing both high and low,
that can sing both high and low.
Oh, my mistress mine, trip no further, pretty sweeting. Journeys end in lovers meeting, every wise man some doth know.
Mistress, mine, oh mistress, oh my mistress.
Mistress, oh my mistress mine, oh mistress, oh my mistress.
So this came from Twelfth Night, and I set it originally for a 14-year-old production of Twelfth Night. And first of all, I set it in a very English way, and then he said, oh no, I want this to have an Eastern European feel. So that was, I had a go, so that was the go that I had at it. But that was O Mistress Mine.
Fantastic, thank you. I just want to introduce, this is Joanna Foster, and Cleo Lane, and I'm Katie Rose. So Rafiq gave me a selection of sonnets to choose from, and I've chosen two that are really, really contrasting, and the first of which you're going to hear now. I just wanted to give you a little introduction into how we've thought of this. One of the themes in the sonnets is whether the appearance of either the beloved or people in our lives can be trusted, whether there is perhaps deception lurking underneath beauty, whether there is hypocrisy underneath shows of power. And we've seen the minister of Shakespeare already. So you may wish to imagine such figures. For this sonnet begins, they that have power to hurt, but will do none. And please choose your own character to fit the bill. This may explain why it sounds a little unusual.
They that have power to hurt and will do none, that do not do the thing they show, then moving others are themselves as stone, unmoved cold, and to temptation slow. They rightly do inherit heaven's grace, and husband nature's riches
from expense.
They are the lords and owners
of their faces,
others but stewards of their excellence. The summer's flower is to the summer sweet, though to itself it only live or die. But with base infection meet, the basest weed outbraves his dignity. For sweetest things turn sourest by their deeds. Far worse than we.
The other song from Twelfth Night is Come Away Death. So, some of this was influenced by Romanian sounds. Again, trying to create this connection with Eastern Europe.
Dum 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 dum. Come away, death, and in sad cypress let me be laid. Fly away, fly away, breath. I am slain by a fair, cruel maid. My shroud of white, stark all with you, all prepare it. My part of death, no one so true did share it. Not a flower sweet on my black coffin, let there be strown. Not a friend greet my poor corpse where my bone shall be thrown. A thousand, thousand sighs to save, lay me away, sad true lover, never find my grave to weep there.
This final sonnet is so famous that it really doesn't need any introduction, I don't think.
Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely, more temperate. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May, and summer's leaves have all too short a day.
Shall I compare thee to a summer's day, to a
fair, just change it.